This is Mission Control, Houston. Very heavy traffic, much in evidence again at the International Space Station. The crew members on board moved on from the final undocking of a Russian cargo ship on Monday afternoon to getting ready for the arrival of its replacement. That's coming up on Wednesday. Commander Gennady Padalka and Flight Engineer Yuri Malenchenko spent the morning training with the Toru. That's the manual system in the Russian segment of the station that is used to fly a Russian ship into a docking with the station if the automated system were to fail. With the next progress set to arrive tomorrow, they got a refresher training session on Toru operations today. Two crew members then spent their afternoon shooting video for a Russian TV show called Lesson from Space. Flight engineer Sergei Revin had time for an on-orbit conversation with the rector of a Russian university, and then he shot video for another Russian project about life in space, finishing up his day with exercise and maintenance on Russian segment systems. Flight engineers Joe Acaba and Sonny Williams spent half a day unloading items in the Japanese cargo ship, the H-2 transfer vehicle, which arrived at the station last Friday. Acaba moved on to taking some readings for a variety of life sciences research projects and then examined samples for the advanced colloids experiment. That's going to examine materials that contain small colloidal particles to learn more about how those particles behave in microgravity. Sonny Williams fed the spiders in the YouTube Space Lab payload. She also spent time talking to a radio station in Woods Hole, Massachusetts, her home state, as well as to CNN, and finished up the day with body mass measurements, as did Acaba and Aki Hoshide. Hoshide's morning was setting up the ultrasound equipment for scans of his leg during the sprint experiment, which is evaluating whether high-intensity but low-volume exercise is better than slower but longer exercise in helping maintain muscle, bone, and cardiovascular function. Hoshide also had his last scheduled period for station familiarization, a station he's been a resident of for about 2 weeks now. Crew members have a variety of science experiment operations on their plan for Wednesday, as well as HTV emergency procedures review before lunch. After lunch, the Russian crew members will get a nap so that they'll be refreshed for Wednesday evening's arrival of the next progress vehicle. The new Russian cargo ship, 48P, launches at 2:35 p.m. Central Time from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan on Wednesday, August 1st, and is scheduled to dock just four orbits later at 8:24 p.m. in the first test of a new flight profile designed to save almost 2 days' travel time for future space station crews.